saint of the days of ignorance, wajabala, wagaira, wagaira. Wherever music is common, wherever someone is listening to music, Allah and Allah's Nabi's curse is coming. My respected brothers and elders, mothers and sisters, in our home every day music is being played. Can Allah's rahmat come? Then can we and our partners see eye to eye? Can our children become pious? Can the children respect the parents? Can the parents respect the children? When every day Allah's curse is coming. وَإِذَا عُصِيتُ غَضِبْتُ Allah says, when you disobey me, insan, I become very angry. وَإِذَا غَضِبْتُ لَعَنْتُ And when I become angry, I curse. وَإِنَّ اللَّعْنَةَ مِنِّي تَبْلُغُ السَّابِعَ مِنَ الْوُلْدِ My one curse will destroy your 7 generations. That person or those generations who have become the target of the curse of Allah, who can save them? Aray, get the greatest alim, Tawiz, Allah's curse is there, they'll never come right. You are not trying to combat a sickness or an illness or a disease. You are trying to challenge the curse of Allah. How can it be challenged? Remove the haram and Allah will remove the curse. And be obedient to me. Baraktu, I send my barakat. وَلَيْسَ لِبَرْكَةِ نِهَايَةً And there's no end to my barakat. There's no end to my barakat. After this, Hafiz ibn Qayyum rahmatullah alayhi commentating on this hadith, right? Look at the devil. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us two things. That on the occasion of good, to make shukr, Allah will reward us. And on the occasion of difficulty, to make sabr, Allah will reward us. The devil has attacked us on both these occasions, and on a happy occasion, put the music full blast, and on a sad occasion, start questioning the authority of Allah. Allah, why to me and why not to someone else? Thereafter he writes, وَمَعْلُومٌ عِنْدَ الْعَامَّةِ وَالْخَاسَةِ أَنَّ فِتْنَةَ الْغِنَى أَشَدُّ مِنْ فِتْنَةِ النَّوْحِ بِكَثِيرٍ وَالَّذِي شَاهَدْنَاهُ وَعَرَفْنَاهُ بِالتَّجَارُبِ That the commentators and the scholars of hadith unanimously agree that though both these voices have been cursed, but the curse that comes on the music is far more than that that comes on that person who mourns in the incorrect manner. This has been unanimously agreed by all the scholars of hadith. Then he says, in my personal experience, عَرَفْنَاهُ بِالتَّجَارُبِ تَجْرُبَةً say, I have understood this place, that whichever place or whichever house or country wherein music become common, music becomes common, Allah puts over them the enemies. This I have seen with my own eyes. Hafiz ibn Qayyim rahmatullah alayhi. Allahu Akbar. مَنْ كَثُرَ سَوَادَ قَوْمٍ فَهُوَ مِنْهُمْ One person told me, a friend of mine from overseas, he one day came here. He mentioned to me, he says that, you know, in our country, it was the month of Ramadan, and there was a concert. Young Muslim girls of Arab origin, when they speak Arabic, you'll feel embarrassed. It was the month of Ramadan, and there was a concert one of the nights. So we mentioned to them that don't attend this concert, music, etc. It is the month of Ramadan. Says, Maulana, you're not going to believe me. It's going to create a shiver in your body. Those young Muslim girls attended this concert, and he mentioned it to me. He says that when the singer went into this hall of his, and the sweat started rolling from his cheek, he took a cloth or a tissue perhaps, he wiped it, and thereafter he threw it into the crowd. These girls took the tissue, or whatever the case may be, they rubbed it on their body, and they said, from today we'll never wash our faces because we have the sweat of these fortunate, blessed, unabated personalities. My respected brothers, when things like this happen, Allah won't get angry. Allah ka ghussa nahi aayega. When things like this, when the ummah is taking courage to do things like this, I mentioned that, my respected brother, it really baffles me that Allah's name is on top of the devil box. It was the month of Ramadan, 1993, in Pakistan. Prior to iftar, the mother calls her daughter, oh my daughter, come and help me in the kitchen. Mommy, it's my program tonight. It's my program tonight. She went in the room. My mother would insist, lock the door. She locked the door. After that, the mother leaves her. The husband, the sons return. Screaming for the daughter, she wouldn't return. The time of iftar comes closer. Calling her by her name, she wouldn't answer. She told her husband, they went, they knocked on the door, no answer. They broke the door. As they entered, to their utter surprise, the girl was, her
face flat on the ground. They tell her pulse, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. She's left the dunya. As I tried to lift her, she grew to the ground. Khuda tu hume samjha de, Khuda hume samjha de. Say Ameen, my brother. How do we lift her? Everyone came, tried, he would tie her, but she would just not stand up. Someone, perchance, moved the devil fox that was in the way. And as they lifted that, her body lifted. They turned her around by lifting the devil box, then only would her body lift from the ground. A ghusl was given to her. The time of janaza was fixed. She left this dunya in the month of Ramadan. Prior to iftar, her eyes glued on the devil box. Allah save us from such a death. Allah save us. We make dua, Allah give her, Allah make her maghfirat. Time to lift the janaza and place it into the hearse. The body just wouldn't move. It's stuck to the ground. I'm giving you current information, relevant incidents. Allahu Akbar. They had to lift the devil box and place the devil box in the hearse with the janaza and drive her to the Qabristan. Her body was placed next to her janaza was the devil box. Oh parents, do we want to see something for our children like this? Imagine that father standing there and he's witnessing just his daughter in front of him, the devil box next to him and her janaza in front. They took the janaza, carrying the devil box with, lowered her into the grave. They left, they lowered her, and they moved the devil box. As they started moving it, this girl stood up and she came out of her grave. There's a kitab that has been printed by Azad wal Darul Ulum, Temptation. Open that kitab and you'll find it. There's a kitab called Temptation. The reference in which magazine this incident came is also written there. The girl stood up from the grave. Again they placed her. Again she stood up. And when she stood up, thousands that were there, their hair stood up on end. They were amazed. They were spun, dropped silent. Finally, she had to be lowered into the grave with the devil box. Allah knows best what happened. Allah knows best what happened to her in the grave. My respected brothers, wallah, it would take a lion's heart to ignore this episode and this incident and to give it a deaf ear and to ignore this. It would take a lion's heart if this cannot create that shiver in that body and let those tears flow and make that azam of throwing that thing out. There's an incident of a person written there also. He was brought to the Qabristan. The hole was dug. When his janaza was brought, about to be lowered, the earth closed up so much so that as though it was never dug. On the hukam of one alim, another grave was dug. About to lower this janaza, the earth closed up. The third grave was dug. When they dug this grave, they seen scorpions and they seen all different types of snakes. They lowered this body into the grave. While we were there, the people witnessed this that were standing at the grave. A snake emerged from his back, coiling around his shoulder, around his neck, and one by his foot, circling around both his feet, and they met at a neutral point at the center, that is the navel, chopping the body into two, being witnessed by everyone who attended the janaza. The alim said, immediately move out and throw the sand. Allah knows best what happened. Allah knows best what happened. My respected brothers, do we need more signs? إذا كان يوم القيامة, on the day of Qiyamah, Almighty Allah will announce. We heard how haram it is. Let's listen to this part. أين الذين ينزهون أسماعهم وأبصارهم عن مزامير الشيطان ميزوهم ميزوهم ميزوهم. کہاں ہیں وہ لوگ جو اپنے کانوں کی حفاظت کیا کرتے تھے موسیقی سننے سے, نہ ہاتھ کو